What do you use LiDAR for? That is the leading question that I get in all my sales calls, you know, from business owners as they try to figure out what all this technology means. So in this video, I've decided to roll up all of our LiDAR applications. They're little 2-minute videos for you so you can see different applications. If this is the first time that we're meeting, hi, I'm Dan Avere. I'm the owner of MODUS. And what MODUS does for companies is helps geospatial companies scale and ramp up using the latest drones, sensors, and workflow technologies. And this helps them reduce site times, revisits, and also eliminating errors. So some quick background on me real quick. I have been in the drone industry for well over 25 years. I've used this technology in combat. I've helped perfect it along the way for government contractors. And in the commercial space, I now work with enterprise and business owners on how to use this technology responsibly and scale it into their business. And we're saving folks a lot of money. So now a quick warning about this video is that this material is at a very high level. Okay, I didn't intend to do a deep dive and I can't on all of these right at this moment. But it's supposed to be designed to give business owners a quick taste and get smart very quickly so they know how to ask deeper questions moving on. And I hope that you guys will absorb this as well. I do hundreds of proposals a year and test these feasibilities. So I'm gonna make you guys a special offer. If you subscribe today, or if you are a subscriber, I should say, and you leave a comment down below on what you would like, I will actually do a deep dive or a deeper dive on a use case and put a video up here for you. And the only way you're gonna see it is you subscribe and get those notifications. So finally, if you stay to the end, I have another surprise for you, a small little gift that I wanna share with you. So when you get to the end of this video, look for what I'm gonna offer you there. All right, let's get started.
There are many applications of LiDAR data. In this section, we will explore several common coastal applications, including mapping, vegetation, and modeling applications. Elevation data is the baseline for all mapping and modeling applications. Accuracy is measured primarily in elevation. In mapping land-based elevation data, this is called topography. Topography is defined as the general shape or form of the land surface, determined by analyzing the elevation of the land. The power and flexibility of modern LiDAR systems make them excellent tools for mapping topography. States use various geographic features to define boundaries, which serve many legal, technical, and general uses. Features may be rivers, washes, mountains, and coastal features. LiDAR can accurately depict these features in their entirety, where surveying would generate interpolation between a limited set of discrete data points. State and local governments use boundaries as management tools to reduce development impacts on the environment and to better protect development from environmental hazards. Depending on the scale of your project, LiDAR also has asset management opportunities. For large areas and geographical corridors, LiDAR is ideal for classifying and modeling assets, such as a transmission power line towers for GIS resource tracking and as-built model tracking. Depending on the resolution, subcomponents can be identified remotely for both engineering, drawing, creation, and discovering other revenue-generating opportunities. Land use planning requires an understanding of the spatial context in which planning decisions are being made. LiDAR provides high-quality base map information needed to support land use planning. Small-scale terrain maps are useful when designing potential development scenarios and evaluating site suitability. Large-scale urban modeling systems use dense three-dimensional representations of building and terrain studies. We will cover this in detail in the data products section. However, digital modeling is the basis for many products. From them, many elements of information can be extracted for layered one-time of them to present information. Principal types of change detection. Geomorphology, the study of the evolution of topographic features created by physical process at or near the Earth's surface. Structural change, the monitoring of man-made objects to detect slight changes in the performance. LIDAR can penetrate through the vegetation and can detect small irregularities in terrain and structures below the vegetation layer. High-resolution topographic data are particularly useful for visualizing and analyzing changes in topography or features such as cliff faces, riverbeds, and fault lines. To help monitor and manage susceptible areas, companies collect information on average rate of change and change in volume to support management, predictive maintenance models, and activity planning. LIDAR is a tabular data and is suited for measuring many kinds of objects. Highly dense LIDAR point clouds are well suitable gathered data for man-made objects. LIDAR data scanned at different points of time are compared to each other to find significant differences between them. These changes can be measured and quantified to assess structural settling, leaning, warping, twisting, or removal. Structural change detection is needed. For example, for monitoring changes of man-made structures in urban areas, such as added or removed buildings and other objects, dam and levee deformation, vertical structure settling or failures. Structural change detection is most valuable, providing damage assessment after storms, earthquakes, floods, tsunamis, and other disasters. Flood modeling benefits from LIDAR's accuracy. Topographic modeling to determine area flood probability, LIDAR is used to create high resolution and accurate surface models, providing 3D simulation for better planning of the structures or buildings on the riverbank and low-laying areas. Due to climate change, most FEMA maps are out of data and are looking for ways to update coastal models. This is valuable to states, local, and insurance. By combining LIDAR data of the coastline surface and associated structure, researchers analyze coastal trends and impact on coastline and property. With periodically capture, this data allows the marine scientist to understand occurrence of coastal erosion over time. LIDAR collects thousands of points per second. Each point is a discrete measurement. When closely spaced, they can become an image. Conversely, when a surveyor builds a map, they measure a number of discrete points and interpolate the differences between them. A LIDAR dataset becomes a historical record that can be used and reused for multiple survey rebate products, depending on the amount of change an area is experiencing. Since LIDAR is actually tabular data, it can be easily processed into several 2D and 3D data sets, accurate topography and contouring. LIDAR data fused with aerial photography shows the 3D view, facilitating the planning of roads, buildings, bridges, and water features. With survey-grade LIDAR, these features can be classified, segmented, and extracted to become highly accurate drafting objects for civil engineers and civil planners. Homogeneously accurate multi-project use. With the increase in the severity of storms and forest fires, the demand to manage our natural forests continue to rise. LIDAR is widely used in the forest industry to plan and manage. There is a need to locate, classify by type and maturity, all the different types of trees. Further, it is becoming increasingly important to have a baseline data set to superimpose other information, such as invasive species effects and vegetation stressing factors. Importantly, being able to track the effects of human influences on our national resources is becoming increasingly important. Some of the information that can be tracked with LIDAR is the measurement of the vertical structure of the forest canopy. This can also be used to measure and understand canopy bulk density and canopy base height for forest health assessments. The root expansion can be assessed both for the forest health and erosion prediction. LIDAR can measure the subcanopy and categorize basic classification of smaller vegetation, allowing better modeling and understanding. Finally, drone aerial LIDAR has a significant advantage over other traditional methods. Being able to fly closer to the canopy, a higher resolution map can be generated for better biomeasurement. While slower than the traditional aerial collection models, it provides better resolution that only time-consuming terrestrial modeling could provide. LIDAR is becoming widely employed in forest fire management. The unique characteristics of LIDAR is its ability to see both the ground and several layers of vegetation. Through classification and characteristic filtering vegetation, density can be identified and mapped. Combined with seasonal weather data, predictive impact models can be made. This is allowing fire departments, municipalities, and forestry agencies to shift from reactive to proactive fire management. LIDAR images help to monitor the possible fire area, which is called fuel mapping or fire behavior modeling. Silviculture is the cultivation of trees as a crop. LIDAR supports the work of large-scale arborists as they determine the best species of tree to be cultivated. Most crops in the East are just a few hundred acres. LIDAR data in GIS can accurately classify and geolocate thousands of trees. Layering of other data to map the advance of invasive insects and regional crop stresses that can affect yields. LIDAR can provide tree measure information such as biomass, maturity, yield, root structure, and more for crop planning and management. LIDAR can create an elevation map of the farmland that is then converted to create a slope, Topography helps farmers find areas of high fertilizer runoff, allowing them to systematically apply fertilizer and water for less runoff and better yields, an efficient use of an expensive component in farming. Sunlight exposure maps are useful in areas with varying topography, such as valleys and topography. Solar exposure predictive data is used to best select plant cultivation in predicted high, medium, and low crop production areas. LIDAR DEM is used to plan parks and tourism areas. Highly accurate land surface models help to find the best areas for playgrounds, trees, and walking trails. 3D imagery of the park generated from LIDAR technology supports present-day use and future development. 3D visualization can present event planners with a virtual experience and accurate spatial dimensions. This also allows space owners to market and rent event spaces in less time and provide transparency on cost per area. The combination of LIDAR aircraft and GPS can be used to find fault lines and measure the geographical uplift. The combination of these technologies was used to find the Seattle Fault. Repeated LIDAR mapping can be used to monitor glacial change and perform coastal change analysis. LIDAR has played an important role in archaeology. Because of the vegetation penetration capability of LIDAR, this allows the detection of micro-topological structures. Used in conjunction with GIS systems, this aids archaeologists in determining buried civilization structures and how best to establish priorities for excavation and preservation.
Okay, welcome back. Hey, I hope this provided you a glimpse of what's possible using LIDAR technologies. Guys, give you a quick hint here. 2021 is going to be year of the drone LIDAR. We've seen it ramping up over the last 5 years. We're seeing companies starting to integrate this technology. In 2020, we have seen more people starting to take bets on LIDAR as they try to recover the losses they lost in 2020. Those guys that are going to adopt within the next 18 months and start to really work this hard and figure it out are really going to be the winners in this market. I guarantee it. So if you want to learn and do this affordably, you know, I have a couple links down below of some courses on LIDAR and mapping by some of the leaders in the drone industry and in the geospatial industry that help you walk in and start to get familiar with this technology as you move forward. By the way, don't forget to check out some of our short videos and other content along the way, as this also all ties in and will help you be successful moving forward. Okay, I'll see you guys in the next video.